Hello everyone, James Migues with listthehouse.com, real estate and property management. Really quickly, listings is what we do, so list your house with List the House. Anyway, to the point. People have been asking me about what's going to happen with this NAR settlement. I really don't know. I've been thinking, I have talked to endless amount of agents regarding the topic. And the one common thing that all of us have talked about and agreed on is that this is very bad for the consumer. I have read articles, I have seen videos. I don't understand how this is good for the consumer, especially the buyer. I've looked and read and talked and no one knows why this is good. Yet, NAR, which I hate to say, I'm not very happy with them right now. They said, oh, this is good for the consumer. Okay, explain it. No one has been able to explain it. And that's the part that kind of makes me mad and frustrated about this. I really think this is very harmful for the buyer because now, first of all, if you look at the statistics and all the information, the average home here in the United States is about $450,000. Or at least down here in Florida. The average salary is about $65,000. Well, so basically, the average, and if you want to buy a $450,000 house, you have to be able to make about $120,000 a year. But if the average home, if the average salary is $65,000, but you need to make $120,000 roughly to be able to buy an average home, then that basically means that the average person cannot buy the average home as it used to be in the past. Now that creates a very huge problem. So now with this lawsuit and this situation with the way the rules have been changing, they intend to make, and they say that no, now it's good because now the buyer's realtor, the realtor that represents the buyer, now has to pay for representationship. Now most buyers, in my experience, I've been doing this for 20 years, all of them are scrounging. Very few people have got money. They don't scrounge around for every dime to buy a house, but the majority of the buyer has to pull money from everywhere they can to be able to afford to buy their home. Now you're going to ask them to pay an additional $5,000, $15,000, $20,000 or more, depends, to be able to have a realtor representationship. Well, the reality is that most buyers will not be able to afford a realtor. So a lot of them are going to go on their own. That's a dangerous thing. People are going to get, people are not going to be happy. I have right now, title company. Title company told me, my friend Rosa, she tells me that she has a situation right now that the buyer is buying the house, did not hire an agent to help him out, and he's already missed the good faith deposit deadline. That particular day was his last day for his inspection period, as well as his second deposit. So technically, he's out of contract. He's going to get screwed if he didn't rush to deposit the money, and two, rush to get the inspection done within a few hours. That's too stressful. And you run the risk of being able to screw up the deal. That's just a slight, small example of what can happen. So no, I think it's a bad deal. It's a bad deal for the consumer. Instead of us going forward, I think we're actually going backwards. So if you want to talk about that, call me. I got my opinion about that. I just don't think this is good for the consumer. It is really bad for the buyer, especially the buyer. Seller, that's a different topic. We can talk about that. Sellers, they're like, oh. And then on top of that, they say, oh, this is, you know, the sellers now will be able to lower the home's prices by 3% because they don't have to pay the buyer's agent. Well, the reality is that the seller is not paying the buyer's agent. It's the listing agent who is sharing his or her commission with the buyer's agent. That's who's paying the commission. As a listing agent, I negotiate with the seller my fee. And if they don't agree with my fee, they can go find another agent. Plain and simple. It's a competitive market. But I require my fee based on my experience and based on what we do for the sale of a property. A lot of agents don't do much. We do. We're list a house. We do marketing for our for all our listings and so forth. So we are worth what what our fees are. And when the time comes, I share my fee with the buyer's agent. So the reality is that, in my opinion, seller's not the one that's paying the buyer's agent. I am. So part of the idea is that now the seller will lower the price by 3%. Really? If you're a seller, the seller's gonna lower the price by 3%, so then that technically will drop the prices of the houses. No. No, no seller's gonna do that. They're gonna try to sell the house as expensive as they can, as they should. The seller nor the realtor is what determines the market. It's the market that determines the market. A buyer will not buy or pay for a house that they don't think it's worth that price. They might not agree because, oh, it's too high, but that is the market. The market sets the market, not the realtor, not the seller. Anyway, I don't want to get more into that, but that's basically my thoughts on this NAR situation that I think is really bad for the consumer. Give us a call. We'll talk. I'll explain a little bit more if you want to. Our fees are our fees, and we'll adjust like everybody else, but I think this is bad for the consumer. Bye. Talk to you soon. Take care.